It is Friday, September 18th, and that means it's time for the news. That's right, guys. I'm back again with my top five tech and gaming news stories. And number one is a story that's been going on for a while. It might not be a huge news story to you, but I think it's something we should all be paying very close attention to. TikTok has officially been banned and has been removed from the Play Store and the App Store in the United States. As of the 20th of this month, two short days, it's going to be gone from the stores. You will not be able to download TikTok anymore. Now, of course, the government in the United States is claiming that TikTok is basically a surveillance app for the Chinese government. We've got a quote here from the Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross. "We have taken significant action to combat China's malicious collection of American citizens' personal data while promoting our national values, democratic rules-based norms, and aggressive enforcement of U.S. laws and regulation." My problem with this is maybe a little bit more nuanced than the quick take might be. And it's something I just want to throw out there and let you guys think about. Whether or not China is involved with TikTok, whether or not TikTok is a surveillance app for the Chinese government, because these things can be potentially debated. What I want you guys to consider is the appropriateness of the action of a president to remove an app they don't like from availability. What precedent does that set? Is there a point where Facebook or Twitter or whoever is disliked by the president so they can shut that app down? Is this a road we want to go down? Is it just the case that this app is actually malicious and should be removed? Talk amongst yourselves. It's a complicated issue. All right, let's get to the fun news now. PlayStation 5 prices have finally been revealed. A lot of you guys probably watched along with me as I live streamed their last showcase where they unveiled the prices. The digital-only edition of the PS5, I think, is the show-stopping piece of news here. $399. It's $100 cheaper than the Xbox Series X, while being $100 more than the Xbox Series S. The standard PlayStation 5 is $499. It's an incredibly compelling price point, and I think that Sony did what they had to do and undercut the Xbox Series X. Finally, the game of chicken being played by Microsoft and Sony appears to be over. We actually have prices. In addition to finding out that November 12th is the release date, actually some retailers threw up their pre-orders, which subsequently all crashed. It apparently was an absolute disaster. I, for one, know of at least one person who was just trying to refresh Best Buy, trying to get their pre-order in and failing over and over to be able to do so. How many of you guys tried to pre-order the PlayStation 5 a couple days ago and were unable to? I'd love to know if any of you guys actually got your pre-orders to go through. Another really interesting thing that Sony unveiled during this last showcase is what they're calling the PlayStation Plus Collection. This appears to be a service that's going to be rolled into your PlayStation Plus service, what you're already paying, and they're basically going to just give you a whole bunch, a big collection of games that will now be downloadable and accessible as part of your PlayStation Plus subscription. Now, this should sound a lot like Game Pass to you because it is very similar to Game Pass, but there is one really big difference. Sony is not putting its new first-party games on this service. They're calling it not sustainable. Now, this is really interesting because Microsoft is doing exactly that. Any new first-party Xbox game will be on Game Pass, whereas when Sony releases a new first-party game, you're not going to get that as part of that service. They're saying, quote, "These games cost many millions of dollars, well over $100 million to develop. We just don't see that as sustainable." So that really brings a really interesting question to this situation. How, in fact, does Microsoft intend on doing it? What is their model? How are they doing exactly what Sony says is not sustainable? Personally, I think it's still a net win because you're getting it. As far as we're aware, they've not said there's going to be a price increase for PlayStation Plus. So this is just more value for your subscription. And I think that this is Sony directly answering back to Game Pass, trying to counter that value and that momentum. What do you guys think about the fact, though, that you're not going to get new first-party games as part of this service, whereas you're going to get them for the Xbox equivalent? What do you think is the difference? Is it simply that Microsoft is making fewer first-party games, so they're not devoting as much money to it? I don't know. I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts down below in the comments. Back to the Xbox Series X. We now know that Microsoft was actually experimenting with several different color variations when building the Xbox Series X, and apparently they decided eventually to just stick with the clean matte black finish. I don't know about you guys, but that burgundy or even that kind of mint green looks pretty slick. Does this mean we're going to potentially get different colored Xboxes as we go forward? They talk about actually going into people's homes and taking measurements and looking at how these things would actually fit in their living room. This is a different approach to what I feel like Sony has taken with their alien spacecraft Wi-Fi router looking console. Personally, the industrial style design of the new Xboxes to me is the more appealing look. It's kind of hard for me to get behind the PlayStation 5's appearance. It looks a little gaudy. I think Sony's always kind of gone with a more quote-unquote futuristic sort of look, whereas Microsoft is really trying to bring in their design cues from some of their other products with this clean, minimal design. Granted, the big black grill on the side of the Series S is a little bit hard for me to stomach, but I do still think that the Series X looks really nice. I think I speak for everyone when I say, can we get the burgundy? Can we get the burgundy Series X? And last but not least, we actually do now have the packaging. The PlayStation 5 is going to come in, and personally, I think it actually looks really, really good. So this is what the full disced version of the PlayStation 5 will look like when it arrives in stores here in early November. But to me, the showstopper continues to be the digital version of the PlayStation 5. And that box, that looks even cleaner. I like the all black look. That is a damn fine looking box. That's a box you might actually want to keep if you're like me and you habitually, compulsively keep the boxes that your electronics come in. That's a good looking box. I do want to highlight what is easily the best comment here. Black box, no black PS5. I think if you take this Wi-Fi router looking alien spaceship and you did an all black version, I think it would look 10 times better. Guys, that's all the news I have for you this time. Be sure to check back every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday for my top 5 tech and gaming news stories. And until this next edition comes out, stay nerdy, my friends. If you enjoy my content, please consider becoming a Scary If Literal member. You'll get access to a whole bunch of emoticons to use with live streams and a shout out on an upcoming video. Thanks, as always, for your continued support.